Today, I'm taking another look at the Altra Torin 4.5 Plush. miles, 8 minutes, 45 seconds per mile, 144 beats per minute today, trying to go for an easy run in the Altra Torin 4.5 Plush. But before I give you my thoughts on this shoe after this run, I do want to go over some disclosures. This is a pair of shoes that I purchased with my own money. No one sent it to me or is paying me to make the video, and no one's going to get a chance to preview any of my footage or my thoughts before you guys get a chance to see this video on YouTube. So with that disclosure out of the way, let's talk about the Altra Torin 4.5 Plush. What we have here is a zero drop shoe. As far as I know, all Altra shoes are zero drop, with 28 millimeters of stack height throughout the shoe in the heel and in the forefoot. You've got Quantic midsole foam in here, and it comes in at a weight of 9.1 ounces. Now, this shoe is definitely a comfortable shoe. The step in comfort is certainly there. On a recovery run day, this shoe feels great to put on your foot. I absolutely love everything that they're doing with the upper on this shoe. There's no structure in the heel. Everything is really floppy. There's a little bit of padding back here, a lot more than the other Altra shoes that I've run in the past, and it's very comfortable. The tongue is lightly padded, but it's not super like puffy, and it doesn't come up real tall, so it's kind of hidden and tucked away just the way that I like it. The rest of the material on the upper is like this stretchy mesh type of material, very breathable. My feet were actually a bit chilly for today, but it's stretchy, very comfortable. Plus, you've got that foot-shaped toe box in here, so there's plenty of room for your feet to move around. Overall, it's a very comfortable experience, even down to the insole. It's not ortho-lite, but they're definitely going for that kind of feel. It's once we get to like the midsole and the outsole that I'm having a little bit of a problem with this shoe. I ultimately can't really tell what this shoe wants me to do, because like the normal way that I'm running in it, every single run that I run in this shoe, I end up with the balls of my feet hurting. It happened to me on my first run, and my second run, and even on my third run as well. The only thing that's been really weird or inconsistent in my experience in the shoe is that on the previous runs, both my feet hurt, and it kind of reminded me of kind of like a Morton's Neuroma type of pain, like a little bit of a sharp pain under the ball of your foot, like in the pads of your foot right in that area. And I would get it, even though this is a really wide toe box and there's plenty of room for feet to splay, I would get it in both feet my first two runs. This run, I only felt it in my left foot. That was the only foot that really felt it, but it definitely felt it to a very significant extent, to the point where I was just trying to figure out which is the way that I can make my foot hit the ground in this shoe that it won't make the pain worse. And so I tried my regular foot strike, which I think is more of a midfoot strike. It's not the cleanest foot strike, but it's, I think, in the realm of normal in terms of foot strike. But as a midfoot range, it just didn't feel great. I tried doing some heel striking instead, maybe a little bit more of a fluid shuffle type of gait, and that didn't really work either. I thought really that's where I was going to be finding the sweet spot on it, but that wasn't it either. It wasn't until like later towards the run where I decided I'm going to try to run as much on my toes on this shoe as possible. Now, I wasn't sprinting today. I was trying to keep it in the easy day kind of category. I'm going to have a harder run tomorrow. So I was trying to basically like tiptoe as I was running. And so that did make me pick up the pace a little bit. So I was running a little bit harder than I was kind of intending. But that seemed to do the trick, which was a really strange way to run in like a zero drop shoe with this much stack height in it. I mean, 28 millimeters is quite a bit to have underfoot in the forefoot. And it's also really weird to have that much of this foam, which I love this foam in the Altra Superior 4.5. I thought having more of it in the Torin 4.5 Plush would give me really great long run, recovery run shoe experience. But even though there's 28 millimeters of stack height, even though there is a very soft insole in here, it just felt a lot of times like I was bottoming out in the shoe, although I don't think that I was actually bottoming out. That's probably the best way I can describe kind of the feeling. Once I was on my toes, which seems counterintuitive because I felt like then I was almost landing directly on the part of the foot that was uncomfortable. But somehow that seemed to solve the problem. And it made me think about my foot strike quite a bit in a way that was mentally fatiguing. And at the paces I was running, kind of running on your toes isn't the most efficient way of running, I think. And so it was a tiring way physically of running as well. So it just was an unusual running experience. Now, I thought, well, maybe the Torin 4.5 Plush is more of a speed day shoe. I don't think that's what it is. That's not really what I got. I just got a shoe that just doesn't seem to agree with me, doesn't pretty much like anything that I'm doing in the shoe. A lot of times when that happens with me in a shoe, I get a sense of like, here's where the shoe just wants to nudge me. It's meant for a certain kind of foot strike or gait or pace or effort level. And I just didn't get a strong sense of that at any point with this shoe. I don't think it's a speed day shoe. But it wants me to run on my toes. So it's very confusing. I'm just having a hard time getting a read on it. At almost 30 miles into the shoe at this point, I don't think it's a break-in issue. I mean, maybe it is, but I feel like if a shoe needs like 50 miles to really break in, and those 50 miles are just really uncomfortable for the most part, the break-in has to be some sort of miracle change that I don't really expect to see from Quantic midsole foam, because I remember I do have experience with Quantic midsole foam in a prior shoe. So I'm not sure if I'm going to continue running in this shoe because it's disagreeing with me. And I think that's perfectly fine. There's lots of shoes that are out there that aren't going to work for every single person. And that's kind of the beauty of the running industry now, is that we do have so many wonderful options for different body types, different types of foot strike, different paces, and different use cases as well. I just can't find any combination of those things that seems to work with me in this shoe. I love walking around with it. I love putting it on. I kind of wish that I could have like a house slipper that felt like the upper of the shoe, because it just feels really nice. But for me running in the shoe, I just don't know that how much more that I'm going to do. I'm not going to like throw away the shoe by any means. I'll hang on to it. Maybe I can find a way to insert it into the rotation, or maybe there's, I don't know. I want to give it more tries, but I mean, how many tries do you have to give a shoe before you're just like, that shoe and I, we're just not, it's not going to work out. And I think that's kind of where we're at on this shoe. So if you've been running in ultras, which ones are the ones that have been really working out for you, specifically in like the long run to the recovery run type of use case? That's kind of what I'm looking for next from Altra. I'd really like to find one that fits for me within the brand. If you want to leave that in the comments, that'd be great. Otherwise, feel free to stop by the live stream that I do every day, or just about every day, on YouTube, 3 p.m. Central Time. I'd love to talk to you guys about it there. That's all I have for today, everybody. Thanks so much for making it all the way to the end of the video. Hopefully you guys are staying safe out there on your runs, and I'll see you in the next one.
Yo, what's going on?